Now, Egyptian police raiding the offices of three U.S.-based pro-democracy human rights organizations, seizing computers and documents. It's part of a massive sweep against these non-governmental organizations. One of the American groups is chaired by a former Secretary of State, another by a powerful U.S. senator. And Mohammed Jamjoom is joining us now from Cairo. It's outrageous what's going on in Cairo right now. Tell our viewers what happened on this day.
Well, Wolf, we spoke to the spokesperson for the General Prosecutor's Office here. He confirmed to us that security forces conducted 17 raids of non-governmental organizations in Cairo today, targeting at least 10 groups across the country. The targeted groups included U.S.-based Freedom House, the National Democratic Institute, and the International Republican Institute. And I spoke a short while ago to Julie Hughes. She's the country director for NDI. She said this was very surprising that at about 12:50 p.m. local time here today, that there was a simultaneous raids of three of their offices in the country here, that laptops were taken, lots of papers, electronic devices, some financial records. And she says that they had heard before that they were under investigation, but that they didn't get any more really information beyond that. This is something that's causing a lot of outrage here. A lot of rights activists in Egypt saying that this is something that wouldn't have even happened during the repressive Mubarak days, during that regime. And a lot of people calling into question just what the ruling military council here is intending to send, what kind of message they're intending to send with these actions. A lot of people here believe that this is a clear indication that the Supreme Council of the Armed Forces are not going to allow a true democratic civil society to flourish in Egypt.
Well, these are organizations that promote democracy, that monitor elections. I don't know if the military rulers of Egypt know that Madeleine Albright, the former Secretary of State, is the head of the National Democratic Institute. Republican Senator John McCain is the head of the International Republican Institute. Do they have a clue what's going on here, how outrageous this is?
Wolf, if they didn't know before, they certainly are getting an indication now. This is a very, very big deal. It's bewildering why the Supreme Council of the Armed Forces or the General Prosecutor's Office, why they would do this kind of an action, especially targeting these American U.S. organizations. It just doesn't make any sense. It's sure to strain U.S.-Egypt relations at a time when there's already a lot of tension and volatility here. You know, even in these post-revolutionary times when things should be calming, when elections are happening, in the past couple of weeks we've seen an increase in crackdowns that are going on against protesters. We've seen a lot of outrage being expressed because military tribunals are still going on. And this is really only something that's going to add more tension, not just within Egypt, but especially between the Egypt-U.S. relationship, which is such a crucial alliance in this region.
Yeah, they're going to have to reverse this and reverse it pretty quickly and start returning those laptops and all those documents. They ransacked those offices in Cairo. Mohammed, we'll stay in close touch with you. Thanks very much for that update.